Hey everybody, welcome to the almost world famous Cactus Atlas. I'm Glenn and we're here in the middle of an Arizona desert. A hot, barren landscape. And I'm here to seek out water. A nice cool surprise hidden somewhere in this desolation. So those are the Vermilion Cliffs. A very famous feature if you're in the northern part of Arizona. And they are absolutely striking to me. Unfortunately, this isn't the most ideal time of day to be filming, but it's the best I could do. And here's a description of the trail, and I can't say it better than they did it, so. Canyon walls rise as you follow a mostly dry wash to the Colorado River. This adventure has no major technical challenges, but scrambling and careful decision-making are needed to choose safe routes over ledges and drop-offs. Named after church-like Cathedral Rock at the head of this small canyon, your journey will take you deeper and deeper through the Kaibab limestone and the Toroweep formations until ending at the river, where canyon debris created Cathedral Wash Rapid. Okay, we're starting the Cathedral Wash Trail. I was wise and I got my all trail situation under control in the car, so I got GPS maps at the ready if I get confused or lost. If I want to keep track of progress, we'll consult it together on this journey. But I'm heading down into this wash now. And the map up front said, proceed underneath the roadway, so make sure you turn right. Because I have another story to tell about what happens when you go left this way. But we'll save that for another time, perhaps. Well, I mean, I guess I'll tell you. Yeah, I hiked that wash as far as I could go, way into the wilderness, back there towards the Vermilion Cliffs. I scrambled up this huge like pile of rocks that was almost like a mountainside. Went about halfway up it and decided all I see at this point are what I assume to be the hoof prints of bighorn sheep. So I was like, okay, that's all. I'm done. But anyway, this looks much more reasonable. I think the stairs here are kind of a clue that this is the way to go. Here's the terrain so far. Just walking down a wash, literally. So whenever there's flash flooding, this is where all the water drains through. It becomes a raging torrent, and you could see all the boulders and debris that the rushing waters move. So one thing that's really super important is check the weather. Make sure there's no rainstorms in this area or even like in regions beyond, because it could rain in a far off place and you could experience flash flooding here. So I've heard scary stories about that. So far, I like this. This is really cool. Okay. This is cool. I heard a rock just fall or something up there. Ah, nice shade. This is really cool. It's like a slot canyon starting to form here. You know I love that. There's a like old mud puddle here. It's only mud now, but proof that there is water down here when it rains. Kind of scary because you could see it'd probably take a lot of force to fashion this canyon. There's like this, I think this is a pothole, is that the term for this? Full of water. I wonder if animals like bighorn sheep come to drink from this. Wouldn't be surprised, it's the only water that I've seen out here. And look, there's life out here in the desert, folks. Tadpoles or something. What are those? Really cool. All right, so I mean, here's like the worst obstacle I've encountered so far, but you just need to step down if you've got long legs like me. Maybe little kids would have to work with us a little bit more, but see? Boom! No problemo. Pretty sure I'm starting to see some more narrow sections up ahead. Hopefully like a really nice tight slot canyon. My favorites. I'm assuming we need to actually go down in there. I don't see any other way. So I think it'd be easiest to enter right here, carefully and gently, just like so. This is where I just came down, and you can see the vermilion cliffs, the hazy cliffs in the distance. Wow, this is a beautiful canyon. I'm trying to think if this will take over as the number one title holder of favorite hikes in Arizona. It's up for consideration. This is like a Nintendo game. I like hopping from like dried mud cake to mud cake. Ooh, my feet were sinking in there. There's still some moisture in that. What other cool experiences like this do you guys know about out here in the state of Arizona? Leave me a comment down below and let me know what I don't know yet. Here's another obstacle. That looks like too far down for me to drop. And you know, I can't believe that's the way to go. There's some deep water in there in that pothole. Oh, I bet you can navigate up here. Imagine though if that was the only way to go to get down there. There are slot canyons all over the place that have, you know, drops like that that I think would require some technical skills. You can see, you can find nice slanted places to go down. I think I see some other ones over here. So if you're just patient and look around, what seems insurmountable at first is easily achievable. Wow, I wish it wasn't so hazy, but it is still pretty early in the afternoon. So as the sun goes down, I'll probably get some cool photos on the way back. But isn't that pretty darn cool? You get some good views though up here of the canyon. And I saw this little spot I thought to descend. Looks pretty doable, maybe over here. So this is what I scaled down. I'm too tired and lazy to film myself climbing down it right now. This is my second hike today already, but so beautiful. All right, let's continue on. I'll put you in the Cactus Atlas cam so you can see what I see. Oh, shoot. So I see potholes. I don't want to get my feet wet either. I didn't come with that in mind, actually. So thinking of that reality is kind of a buzzkill at the moment if I have to do that. I'm not sure yet. I'll probably navigate around this side. Holy moly. All right. Keep in mind I'm hauling some pretty heavy gear too. So this isn't, this is kind of slick. Wonder if we went up on the second tier around that way. Would that be a better idea? I called that right. I did not want to go into those pools. So as I was coming this direction, I stuck to the right and came up to this pink rock. And it's a pretty far drop, maybe about 10 feet. But anyway, staying up against the edge here, keep in mind I'm hauling all this equipment too, the dangling camera bags and all that, my batteries. But I chose wisely, as the old crusader said in Indiana Jones, part 3.
You chose wisely.
Okay, that was actually kind of scary. I was nervous because there were a couple spots where I was holding on and my upper body strength was all that was going to save me if I fell. And I don't have much of that. I'm trying to build some up. But... oh, that was the... that is my vote for number one scary spot of the day so far. Yes, I'm a wimp. I'm okay to admit it, actually. Because, you know, even though I come out and do these things, I'm a human being and I get nervous too. I'm sticking to my plan and staying on this stuff because we got more like potholes down here, these little pools of water. It's kind of weird too. You see how the mud was drying previously? And it cracked, and then there's a fresh layer of water on top now. It's not hard to see too. You can see people's footprints. So you kind of get it like a sense, you have like a spidey sense, even when you don't even realize it, of where other people have walked. Because everybody's almost certainly doing the same route that I'm doing. And you have these like interesting little convenient spots to help get down places, but sometimes they're a little trickier than you think. You just gotta take your time, think through each step, and it's no problem. And then now, I think we get to relax for a little bit as we walk through this flat section. We'll try to make up some time now, and I'll check back in when we get to some really cool stuff. This has turned out to be an adventure of adventures, man. This is so cool. And I still have not seen a single person on the trail yet. So I am completely alone out here. Amy knows my whereabouts, but that's about it. Every once in a while I come upon like something that looks like a really steep drop off where I'm not gonna be able to get down. I'm seeing this for the first time with you right here. That looks deep, whatever that is. Whoa, do I have to go down there? No way. So that can't be possible unless you have to like go all the way over there and drop down, but that's pretty gnarly. I can't believe that. There's gotta be a way around. Let's go survey up high. That's usually what does the trick for me, is to do that. Yep, that's what it was. So, don't look down. Oh my goodness, that's deep. So that's all. Nothing technical, it would seem. Just like the sign says, decision-making skills. Like, really think about something before you attempt it, because there's probably an easier way if you're doubting yourself. That's my best advice. This is a really rare treat, though, to find something like this dramatic and this, I would say, for lack of a better word, accessible to people like me, I guess. I didn't mean like ADA compliant or anything like that, but I'm still struggling to see how we're gonna get down there now, though. This is kind of worrisome. Because look how far down that is. Holy canyon. So the trail goes up here. So I guess I might have to scramble down something on that side. That's all I could think, or I took a wrong turn and I should have gone to the right. But let's continue. Let's have faith and follow the footsteps that came before us. Okay, so unless there's some kind of trick to it, I scaled down a little ways and then it was a pretty steep drop off, so that appears to be a dead end. What I'm thinking is it looks like there's footsteps on that side, so if I can figure out how to get on the right side, that's more sensible. All right, so the only thing I could see is right over there in that corner. like go out that ledge and just scooch down that on my butt, probably feet first, slowly, and get down there. Just make sure I can get back up. That's the main thing. And then probably go underneath that thing to emerge over there. Sounds easy, right? Yep, that looks about right. We're gonna scale down this right here, just like so. All right, that wasn't too terrible. And now I'm gonna have to stick underneath this thing, which is not easy for a 6'2" gentleman such as myself. I don't have a helmet either, so I wanna be really careful here. Okay, don't look down. This thing, dude, this is a freaking adventure. And now, we probably just have to climb down right here and continue. All right, so I stuck to the high ground and I see lots of footprints in the canyon below, making me think that might be the best route, because if I stay up here, I guess I could scale down right over there too and get to the same spot. So let's go do that, maybe stay to the high ground for now. So I'm gonna be real with you guys. This is pretty intense for me. So far, I found a way over every obstacle, but it really is like, you know, there are times where if you have a fear of heights, you might get that tingle in your neck. I get a little bit of that vertigo, but been dealing with it okay. Just passed another hiker though, and she came from, I think that's the only one that I saw. There's a car in the parking lot. She was scooching on her butt underneath that section there. So I'm wondering if that's what I'm gonna have to do. We're getting closer, I think. My GPS isn't working right now, but we have to be really close. More potholes. That one looks pretty deep too, on this side. I'm trying to figure out, you know, she came from that way. So I didn't have to scooch my butt underneath that thing, I don't think, because I think I should be able to just head right up this thing, I think. Okay. You know, where there's some will, everything is so very doable in this thing. So I highly encourage those of you adventurous ones to come try this. So I do expect this to open up to the Colorado River. I don't know if it's my imagination, but I see like a glimmer of light around that edge. My GPS, when I check it, I think it's not, I'm not getting a signal down here, I don't think, because this canyon's too deep, I guess. But yeah, we're just gonna head around that corner. I'm so hoping it's there. I wanna enjoy that cherry Coke I brought with me. Hopefully it's still cool. And now that I know that hiker's long gone, and now I think I am the only one, you really feel that sense of being alone. And, you know, even though you can go slow and be careful, it's like there's always imminent danger in a place like this, and it's thrilling. I love the thrill, you know, that's why I do some of this stuff. Let's take a minute and pause to see how high these cliffs are above me. I mean, this is so crazy cool, amazing. I paused and listened. And I'm pretty sure I can hear rushing water, rapids of some sort. I think this section of the thing does have some rapids, the Colorado River, but I don't think it's like hardcore, like class five or whatever the, I forget all the terminology with that from other videos I've seen. Starting to widen up and I hear the water even louder now. I think it's around that left turn up there. This is luxury now. It's nice and flat. You wouldn't know that around that bend is a workout. And I sure hope I remember how to go back. In terms of the routes, I think I will. But anyway, look at these looming cliff walls. I mean, this is so much deeper than I ever would have imagined. It's hard, you probably don't understand the sense of depth while looking at this video, I'm guessing, but it's big. It's deep. Sometimes I'm disturbed why I have so much to say in situations like this. I do it for you guys. I just like to share my world and share things that not everybody has time to go see. I'm fortunate to live within a feasible distance of these types of things. Ah, yes. It's gotta be right beyond that. I keep saying it though. Hopefully you can hear the rushing water now though. Oh my God, we found it. We found it. The Colorado River, folks. Check it out. There are rapids here. Look at that. We're near something called Lees Ferry. The way you cross over to get to the other side, the north rim of the Grand Canyon. Look at this. This is fantastic. This is heaven. Look at this river flowing, the Colorado River. We did it. I can't believe we did it.
It's not every day that you get to go chill out by the Colorado River after coming down a really awesome slot canyon. Woo. I love this. This is what life is all about. Okay, so one last thing to do. I brought this cherry Coke. It's still cold. I got it down here cool, I should say. And I'm gonna put my feet into the Colorado River and enjoy this cool beverage. I wanna say icy cold, but it's not, it's cool. Woohoo! But this river is icy cold. Oh my God, that is cold. Oh, that is freezing. Woohoo! That's cold. I'm getting charged up with the sugar. Oh yeah. All right, well, I'm gonna have to put away the camera gear and stuff so I can hightail it out of here. I'm just walking around and letting my feet dry now so I can get ready to hike back up. I need to get back home to Phoenix tonight, if you can believe that, so I can work tomorrow. And that's like a 4.5 hour drive. And it's gonna be like 5 o'clock or so, 5:30 by the time I exit this canyon, I think. So I'm gonna get home like at 9-10 o'clock at night tonight. But it's absolutely worth it. I know you guys probably think I'm absolutely crazy, and I am. But this is what I did with my Labor Day holiday weekend with the extra day off. Boom.